Welcome to First Presbyterian Church, Lewisville. We're sure glad to see each and every one of you here today, and that we hope you find what you're looking for in this place today in the house of the Lord. Now, if everyone will sign the ritual of friendship pad located in the seat. And we have a minute permission from Leanne Hargrove.
For three things this month. We are asking for CCA, that will you bring in just bags of fresh fruit, things that will keep fairly well, like oranges, grapefruit, apples, something like that that will keep fairly well. That's what CCA needed this month. We are still needing five packs of chewing gum for what Martha is shipping off to Afghanistan for our troops. And we are also, for troops, looking for simple board games and decks of cards. They want something to get to games to play when they are having some downtime. So those are the three things that we are asking you to bring. Thank you.
Today's announcements. They're going to be selling Easter lilies, and there's a form in your bulletin there. The men's Bible study group meeting on Tuesday nights. Still looking for more men. We'll get them. And we'll miss you in here as Karen, our secretary, is going to be leaving to be working with her husband. And she'll be leaving at the end of the month. Yes?
Did everybody hear that? If you're wanting to contribute to a gift for Karen, you can use one of the pew envelopes and on the front of it put Karen, and we will be getting her something special. So be sure and do that. I wanted to let the session and the pastor nominating committee know that next Sunday there will be a joint meeting with the pastor nominating committee, the session, and representatives of the Committee on Ministry. And that will be at 3:00 on Sunday the 18th. So I'm just letting you guys know that ahead of time. I'll send out more information to the session about our business side of that, but the PNC will be invited to come for that joint meeting, and COM representatives will be showing up at 3:00. Okay.
Everybody will rise. We'll have a call to worship. The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The degrees of the Lord are sure, making wise the simple.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing in the heart. The command of the Lord is clear.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true and righteous altogether.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer.
So I'll remain standing as we worship this morning. If you're glad to be here this morning, say amen.
Amen.
That's good. With the rain, it's a great time to be here in the house of the Lord. Hope that you've come today just to be excited not only about being in the house of the Lord, but going to have some great music today from a group of young kids. as well. So as first, as we get started this morning, God of grace, God of glory.
Assurance is this: there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do.
God sent the Savior, who redeems us all unworthiness. In Jesus Christ we are forgiven.
Give thanks.
Since God has forgiven us in Christ, let us forgive one another. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Now greet those seated near you and share Christ's peace.
Peace be with you.
Praise the Lord and greatly to be praised.
gospel is read this morning. As we have listened to the hymns and spiritual songs of the faith, let us remember our baptism. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Okay, are we on here? Okay, good. I guess I won't move around much. That wasn't my plan, but God works in a lot of different ways. God blessed us with your music today. And I know that you have been a blessing wherever you have gone this week. And I thank you on behalf of this congregation and look forward to the rest of the music that we will hear during this worship service.
Selling cattle, sheep,
and doves, and the money changers seated at their tables. Making a whip of cords, he drove all of them out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins that the money changers and overturned their tables. He told those who were selling the doves, "Take these things out of here. Stop making my father's house a marketplace." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and will you raise it up in 3 days? But he was speaking of the temple of his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You know, there's a lot of pop idols. There have been some that have come, some that have gone. You might think of people as different pop idols, but I heard recently that we have a new idol in our lives. It is an idol that actually causes much anxiety in people's lives because it has become people's lives. It holds on to people's lives for them. How many of you have a smartphone? Okay? If you have a smartphone, you know that one of these holds on to things that you don't have in your head. You don't know every phone number in this, do you? We used to know everybody's phone number in our head. We no longer know that. Many of us keep a calendar on here instead of on some other place. If we were to lose this, what would happen? Oh my gosh. There is a new anxiety and phobia. I don't know if they've actually put it in the DSM-4, but they're talking about it as a new phobia that people are going around and they're making sure. Now, guys, you usually keep this in your pocket, so you may be every 5 minutes checking to make sure you've got that cell phone in your pocket. Or women, you may be doing the same thing in your purse or wherever you keep your cell phone, just to make sure it's close to you, because if you don't have it close to you, then what's going to happen? Wow. I told myself that during Lent, what I am giving up is the need to have this with me all the time. So, the way I've started doing this, little by little, remember everything has to be done, you know, little by little, you can't just like go cold turkey, is I will leave this at home while I go to the grocery store. Okay? I figure I can handle an hour. And that way, nobody can call me and distract me from what I'm trying to do, and there won't be any emergency that I can't take care of when I get back within that hour. You know? Okay. So, that's something that I'm dealing with. Okay. Now, we can kind of make fun of the idols that we have now. But we've got idols that are much more serious than our smartphones, don't we? We have things in our lives that are keeping us from a deeper relationship with God, preventing us from worshiping God every day of our lives in the moment because something else is more important than that, don't we? Just think for a minute about what those things are for you. Donald Neary says this: God asks us in Jesus to share his anger when in his name people's dignity is diminished, or love is abused, or the poor are exploited, or when he himself is neglected. This is true religion, to act justly, love tenderly, and walk humbly with our God. Jesus walked into that temple because those people were not walking in to worship God. They were dealing with the money changers. They were dealing with all the things within the law that they thought they needed to deal with before they could go before God, but those things were keeping them from God. And Jesus was ticked off. Now, there are very few times that Jesus gets really angry. Think of some of the times. Now, the times that he gets mostly angry are the times when people have not lived a truly righteous or just life, or when they have been cruel to others. So, Jesus is truly trying to live out the great commandment and trying to ask others to do that, and does get angry when others don't. Love God with all your heart and soul and mind and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. If you're not doing that, Jesus is going to get mad. And he does. What is that thing in your life that is keeping you from really having a relationship with God? Really having a relationship with your friends, with your family, with those in this community? From letting go? What is that? Whatever it is, one step at a time, let that thing go a little more and a little more and a little more until it's not an idol in your life anymore. Until it's something that won't become a phobia when you lose it, that you fear it, that it'll stop your life because it's gone, because it won't stop your life. Will it? We're asked during Lent to be remade into God's image in Christ. And we can do that by fasting, knowing that the feast of the Paschal meal is to come. Okay? And if that's true, then let's think about this. Let's fast from judging others. Let's feast on Jesus Christ dwelling in them. Let's fast from fear. Let's feast on the healing power of God. Let's fast from gossip. And let's feast and builds up. Let's fast from cynicism. Let's feast on gratitude. And let's fast from self-protection and feast on truth. Jesus walked up to that temple, saw the masses of people, the exchange of money, people bringing up things that they had to exchange in order to come in, to be made pure, and saw that as preventing them from actually being in relationship with God. Jesus came with a new law, didn't he? But was it really a new law? No. It was the true interpretation of God's law. To love God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, your strength, and your neighbor as yourself. And if you can do that and not let the idols of your life get in your way, then that anger of Jesus has settled in you to help you become strong in the faith that God, yes, God, if you are still, is God. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Everybody talking about that wedding going. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Oh my Lord. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Everybody talking about that wedding going. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Oh my Lord. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Everybody talking about that wedding going. Everybody talking about that wedding going there. Oh my Lord.
Well, I've read about the streets of gold, and I've read about the throne.
This is the time where members give their tithes and offerings, and guests give as they are able. With gladness, let us present the offerings of our life and labor to the Lord. Remember the words of the Apostle Paul: "One who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. One who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully." We now receive our morning offering.
Thank you.
What can we give that has not already been given to us? Surely no gift of ours can repay Christ's gift of love. Therefore, we offer ourselves with thanksgiving for new life in the Spirit, and then place before you what we have in response to your love. Use us in ways that fulfill your plan for creation, and bless what we give so that others may learn of your ways. Amen.
Amen.
Again, I'll ask you to pull out the prayer concerns, and as I pray, have those names in your heart. Sometimes we need to wait for your still small voice, even as we wait to pray. Each thing that we have received from you, it came from you, O God. Each thing for which we hope, from you, from your love, it will be given. Kindle in our hearts within a flame of love for our neighbors, for our foes, and for our friends, for our loved ones, and for the lowliest thing that lives, to the name that is highest of all. We seek courage to worship you with our whole selves, every moment of our days. For to do so may change us. We may have to give up those idols, those things that keep us from relationship with you. Move with us and shelter us when we fear the emptiness of our silence. Because our silence is where we find you. Fill us and move us when futility and frustration threaten to paralyze us, that we may be living and loving hands and feet, instruments of your acts. Help us to be mindful of our connectedness to you and to all creation through the Spirit. And now, O God, we pray for persons that we know are in need of healing. Whether it be physically, emotionally, or spiritually. We pray for leaders who are in need of direction. That they may seek wisdom. We pray for lives in need of caring, for for those who are alone, for those who are being abused, for those who are in war, for those who are hungry, for those who are recovering from the tornadoes that ripped through the states just north of us. We ask, O God, the hands that can help them be with them now. O God, may the whole world today know a moment of living with purpose and with enthusiasm and with courage to do your will. And may that moment be many moments then that grow, so that we may then feast instead of fast. And this we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who taught us this prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Groups. I have done a lot. I even sung. I was with the Heritage Singers at Howard Payne University. I can tell you honestly that these are a fine group of young men and women, and it shows in their actions, it shows in their faces, in their testimony. And I just want you right now, because they're going to sing one more time, but let's give them a big round of applause.
Colors of fall through fragrance of spring.
Those who don't know Christ.
We need to make sure that they know their lives will never be the same when they take Christ into their heart. So, go, therefore, and make disciples. And may the love of God, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and in all time. Amen. I invite you to come say hi, or please welcome.